Hi, welcome to Analytic Nerd Channel. In this channel, I shall be covering all the subjects and topics related to data science and data analytics. For example, Python, then statistics, machine learning, SQL, Power BI, Tableau, MongoDB, then deep learning, computer vision, NLP, generative AI, time series analysis, and many more. So do stay tuned to my channel, Analytic Nerd. And to begin with, I have basically started with the SQL series playlist. Here we can see this is the playlist of the SQL series. And there are many more videos to come in the upcoming days for SQL. And all these topics are very much important for your SQL, not only for knowledge purpose, but also for industry purpose and interview purposes also. So do stay tuned. And the link of this playlist I shall be pasting in the description of this video, so you can directly click the link and can get access to the full playlist for this SQL series on this Analytic Nerd channel. Now to begin with, basically here a database I have created like class 1, and a database is a storage where you can store your tables and you can use those tables under that particular database. So for example, class 1 is a database, and you just have to execute this line where you have to write the command use class 1 and hit the execute button. And here two hypothetical tables I have created that basically display the employee details of a certain organization. These are all just hypothetical values and hypothetical tables I have created. Like for example, this is the first table. If you want to display all the records from a particular table in SQL, you have to write the command select asterisk from emp2_2. And here you go, all the fields, there is all the column names like EID, name, etc. of this particular table are shown here. That is applicable for other tables also. So here, hypothetically, I have taken this first column EID that represents the EID values, employee ID values for employees. And I have inserted here the details of 132 employees. All are hypothetical values, arbitrary values, just for explanation purposes. So if you go down, you can see that total there are 132 rows. That means there are 132 EID values, and employee ID values are always unique, which are not never repeated. So that means there are 132 employees in this organization that I have taken hypothetically. And accordingly, this will be under the EID column. Okay, then in the second column, you have the name that corresponds to all the employee names. These are again arbitrary and hypothetical names that I have taken here. ADDR1 column, it corresponds to, you know, all the address 1 values of the employees. ADDR2 corresponds to the second address line of all the employees. City column corresponds to the city values of the employees, that is to which city a particular employee belongs to, that kind of record. Then again here, arbitrary, that is basically imaginative, or you can say hypothetical phone numbers I've inserted under the phone column for each employee. So phone numbers are there for all the employees. Then email column is also what I've created. The CSV files are also available in the description of this video. So there you can, that is the link by which you can access those CSV files are also available in the description of this video. So you can download those CSV files and follow my videos for your practice. This is another column that I've created, email column, that again consists of the employee email IDs, hypothetical values. DAB corresponds to date of birth of all the employees. DOJ corresponds to date of joining of all the employees. So DOB stands for date of birth of all the employees. DOJ stands for date of joining of all the employees. There is the employees who have joined the organization on a particular date. Similarly, there is another table which is emp_inc that constitutes of other associated details of the employees. So execute, select this line number 3, select asterisk from emp_inc, and from this table the particular fields and their record values are displayed here. Okay, so this is another hypothetical table that I've created consisting of hypothetical values of employees. So here you can see EID column. EID column is common between the two tables, that is between emp2_2 and between emp_inc. EID column is one which is common. Now if you follow the cursor and look at the bottom right hand side, 79 rows are there. So it means that this table consists of 79 values. Under EID column, you have 79 values. This is DEPT, that represents the department to which the departments to which the employees belong. Like, for example, OPERN stands for Operations Department, ADMN stands for Admin Department, MISC stands for Miscellaneous Department, HRD stands for Human Resource Department. So these are some hypothetical department values that I have tagged for the employees, which I have hypothetically created here. Then DESI stands for designation column. That is, what is the designation of a certain employee? So the designation values, for the employees are stored under this column. And the last column is the salary column, where I have entered hypothetical salary values for the employees. So if you select both these two tables, that is lines 2 and 3, and hit the execute button, then records for both the tables are shown. At first, you have this EMP2_2 table, and below it, you have the EMP_INC table. Now, as I stated earlier, that in this EMP2_2 table, it has got 132 rows. That means 132 EID values will be there, which are unique, not similar, never repeated. That means there are 132 employees in this organization. Okay, now out of these 132 EID values, 79 values, that is 79 EID values, are present in the second table, EMP_INC, under the EID column. And correspondingly, those 79 EID values have records in this table also, that is for department, designation, and salary. So that means that out of 132 employees, there are 79 employees who have records in both the tables. Because an EID value, nothing but an EID value basically identifies a particular employee. So there are 79 employees who have got records in both the tables, where EID is the common column between them. Now, in this particular video, I'll be just explaining the inner join operation. Because joining operation, you know, is a very important operation that happens in SQL, where we can join and display multiple records from multiple tables. Okay. So let us look at that particular operation, which is like here. In line number 90, if you see, select is again used for displaying whatever you want to display. Select e.eid, name, city, phone. Now see, EID is available for both the tables. And the name column, EID column is available in both the tables. Name column, it is available only in this first table, which is EMP2_2. Then you have the city column, which is also available only in this first table, that is EMP2_2. Then you have the phone column, which is also available in this first table, which is EMP2_2. And then onwards, we have these three columns from where we want to display the records, like DESI, department, salary. DESI, DEPT stands for department, as I told you, and salary. So designation, department, salary, these three columns, they belong to the second table, EMP_INC. So with the help of inner join operation, what it does is that it will help you to display only the common records coming from both the tables. Because here, as we can see, name, city, phone, they basically belong to the first table, EMP2_2. Designation, department, salary belong to the second table, that is EMP_INC. Then after that, you have to write the table from which you are basically displaying records. So that's why this keyword from, you have to write in the next line, like I have written line number 91. Then write the table, EMP2_2, and here you can give an alias name, that is another name for EMP2_2 that I can use in this particular SQL query. So EMP2_2 can be used as E also in this particular query. In the next line, you have to give inner join command. This you have to write. And then in the next line, you have to write the second table name, which is EMP_INC in our case, and the alias name you can give as EI. So here, by just using EI also, we can refer to EMP_INC. And on which table? So, and on which, like, column, not table, on which column? Here, when you write this on keyword after that, you have to use the common column, which is available between the two tables. And as I told you earlier also, that is for these two tables, EMP2_2 and EMP_INC, the common column is which column? It is only the EID column, which is common to both the tables. And in SQL, you can, this is not case sensitive, like even if it is in uppercase in the table, while writing the query, you can use lowercase also. So that is why I've written E.EID is equals to EI.EID. What is E here? E here is nothing but your this table, EMP2_2. And when EMP2_2 is written just before the join, it becomes your left table. And similarly, is equals to, that is after you have written E.EID. is equals to EI dot EID. So that means this EI, it basically corresponds to this particular table EMP underscore INC. Okay, that has been written after inner join. So after the join statement or after the join keyword, whatever table you write, that table becomes your right table. So EMP2 underscore 2 becomes your left table and EMP underscore INC becomes your right table. Okay, EMP2 underscore 2 becomes your left table, EMP underscore INC becomes your right table, and inner join will do what? It will basically first find out the common records between the two tables. Only the common records between the two tables. On the basis of what? On the basis of the EID column common between the two tables. So how many EID values are common between the two tables? There are 79 EID values which are common between the two tables. Okay, so that's why only those 79 EID values will be displayed, and correspondingly those 79 EID values have got name values, city values, then your phone values in the left table, which is your EMP2 underscore 2, that is here. And also those 79 EID values have records in the second table also, that is in EMP underscore INC. There they have got the records or the values for designation column, department column, salary column coming from this particular table EMP underscore INC. So those 79 EIDs which are common between the two tables, only those will be displayed. There is those 79 EID values. And those 79 EID values have records in both the tables, that is under name, city, phone columns coming from EMP2 underscore 2. Those will be displayed, as well as from designation, department, salary columns coming from the right table EMP underscore INC. Those will be also displayed. So select lines 90 to 94 and hit the execute button. And here you go. If you follow the cursor and see the right bottom right hand corner, 79 rows, because there are 79 common values of EIDs between the two tables. And those 79 EID values have records in both the tables under name, city, phone, designation, department, salary columns. So there are 79 employees who have got common records. There is 79 employees who have got records in both the tables. If you scroll down, see no null values here. No null values here. So in this video, I have just explained this inner join operation. If you can click the I button on the top, then you can visit the entire video where I have explained all the concepts related to the joining operations and other related important topics also for this video. So if you have liked this video, you can kindly hit the like, share and subscribe button and press the bell icon for notifications. And thank you.